let them know from the door. We won a lot of battles, but there's more in store. If you're gonna be a soldier, know what you're fighting for. We the battle axis, God's weapons of war. We can't be defeated, let them know from the door. We won a lot of battles, but there's more in store. If you're gonna be a soldier, know what you're fighting for. We the battle axis, God's weapons of war. Before you go to battle, you should know what you up against. When Yah sends his army on a mission, it ain't no defense. Have the latest weapons up, go and learn Kung Fu, or you can read the Art of War written by Sun Tzu. You gon' need all of the above when we come through. When Yah sends the order out,
what can you go to?
You can go to, wow, man. Well, the Bible teaches that we can go to any scripture to prove, but we can go to
how do we identify them today? Because okay, anybody can say they're a child of God.
Genesis, I believe.
When you can go to Genesis, you can go to Genesis 49. Yeah, you can go to Deuteronomy 33. But this is the pivotal chapter right here, Deuteronomy 28 and 15. See, we had a contract with the Most High God. If we kept this command, we'll be set on high above all races. But it's the flip side to that. If we break them, guess what? We'll be on the bottom, bro.
Yeah, that's true.
You understand that? Who got that? Read this out.
28 and 15.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, verse 15. But it shall come to pass, if thou wilt not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God.
Moses was giving the children of Israel guidelines. If we will hearken, if we will not hearken, read on up.
Unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to observe, to do all his commandments.
To observe, to do, brother, read on up.
And his statutes, which I command thee this day, that all these curses.
There's a curse of good or a bad thing.
Both.
We hear that a lot of times, but the curse is straight up bad, brother.
Okay.
Read on up.
That all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee.
So God said for breaking his laws, he was going to make bad things happen to us. Let's read some of them.
Cursed shall thou be in the city, and cursed shall thou be in the field.
What fields were we cursed in, brother?
Over here, most definitely.
What field, though?
Cotton
fields, brother. Guess what? We bring it up to today. What fields are we cursed in today? The work field. First fire, last hire, brother. All these things still apply to us, brother. It may be a different day, but guess what? It's still the same curses, brother.
Right.
Read on up.
Cursed shall thy basket and thy store.
Cursed shall be thy basket and thy store. Meaning we won't own many black businesses, brother. You say you're an artist, but do you have a company over there in China?
No.
Do you have a company in Russia? Read on up.
Cursed shall be thy fruit of thy body and the fruit of thy land.
And the fruit of thy land, going into the seeds that you have, your children, brother. Guess what? When they come out the womb, they're going to be cursed too, brother. Let's jump down. Give me verse 28.
Deuteronomy 28 and 28. The Lord shall smite thee with madness.
Guess what? We spend with madness as a nation of people, brother. Look at our people that's out here, brother. Even our people in here drunk. Going hallucinate, going crazy. Some type of madness is going on, brother. These are all curses that was placed on us because we break God's commandments. It's as simple as that. Just keep the commandments. Because how many commandments are there, brother?
Well, there's a lot of them, man. It's like, I can't even count.
Yes, it's a lot of them. It's over 600 commandments. But guess what? We was only taught that it was what, 10? But the Bible has many commandments in there from Genesis to Revelation, brother. Read on up.
Cursed shall be the fruit of thy body and the fruit of thy land. The increase of thy kind and the flock of thy sheep. Cursed shall thou be when thou comest in.
Cursed shall thou be when thou comest in, when you born. Read on up.
And cursed shall thou be when thou goest out.
And cursed, guess what? When we die, brother. Read on. Because a lot of times, guess what? We get killed unjustly. You see the police shooting us down, we shooting each other down, brother. That makes no sense, brother. Read on up.
The Lord shall send upon thee cursing, vexation, and rebuke in all that thou sendest thine hand unto. For to do.
To some.
For all
the things that we set our hand to do, brother. That's why these things never prosper for us as a nation of people. Give me Joshua 1 and 8 right quick. Read on up.
Until thou be destroyed.
Until thou be what?
Until thou be destroyed.
Black on black crime.
Until thou be destroyed.
Police brutality.
Until thou be destroyed.
Until thou be destroyed. This is the only thing that's going to cause us to prosper. How are we get up? Read this up.
This is Joshua. This is Joshua. Chapter 1, verse 8. This
book of the law shall not depart out of thy mouth.
So this Bible shouldn't leave our mouths, brother, or our actions. We are not.
But thou shalt meditate therein day and night.
Wait a minute.
Day and what?
Day and night.
Read on up.
That thou mayest observe to do according to all that is written therein. For then thou shalt make thy way prosperous.
Read that last part again, huh?
For then thou shalt make thy way prosperous.
Then thou shalt make thy way prosperous. When we do what, brother? Keep the commandments, brother. All praise to that, because I see you got your bird. You want it? That's a commandment. You're starting to wear your fringe. You got to check it out on this, brother. The next thing you need to do is, guess what? Gather amongst the people, bro.
That's
you understand?
Because
guess what? Man. You got different administrations that we can use, brother. You know, understand that, brother? We need things like that, people with your type of skills level, brother, so we can all come together, brother. Read on up.
Verse 20. The Lord shall send upon thee curses, vexation, and rebuke, and all that thou sellest thy hand unto, for to do until thou be destroyed.
Until
thou be destroyed.
Read on, huh?
And until thou perish quickly.
Read on.
Because of the wickedness of thy doings.
Because of the wickedness of what?
Of thy doings.
Doing drugs.
Because of the wickedness of thy doings.
Whoremongering.
Because of the wickedness of thy doings.
Black on black crime.
Because of the wickedness of thy doings.
Read on, huh?
Whereby thou hast forsaken me.
Thou hast what?
Thou hast forsaken
me. We have forsaken the Most High God because none of our people keep his laws as a nation of people. They go to church on what day?
Saturday.
What day do the Bible tell us to go on?
Saturday,
brother. Give me verse 32.
28 and 32 of Deuteronomy. Thy son and thy daughter shall be given into another people.
Shall be what?
Thy son and thy daughter shall be given into another people.
Whose sons and daughters is given into another people, brother? Don't you see how these curses only line up with one people, brother? Read on, huh?
And thine eyes shall look and fail with longing for them all the day long.
Read on, huh?
And there shall be no might.
Economic might.
And there shall be no might.
Military might.
And there shall be no might.
Read on, huh?
In thine hand, the fruit of the land and all thy labor shall a nation which thou knowest not eat up.
Brother, we didn't know this nation, brother, when they came and got us from the west coast of Africa. They ate up all the fruits of our brothers, the tribe of Gad, the Native American Indians, and the Aztecs, the tribe of Issachar, brother. They ate up the fruits of this land because this land was very bountiful and plentiful in fruit, brother. They took all that from them. Even the Mexicans in Mexico don't own Mexico, brother. You understand that, brother? They ate up the fruits of this land, brother, because we're not keeping God's commandments.
Yeah.
Brother and sister, y'all read the Bible? Y'all believe in the Bible? Y'all know who y'all are according to the scriptures? Who are you, sis? What nation do you come from? Because African American not in the Bible, sis. These are nationalities are not in there. Guess what? That's a curse in the Bible too. Give me verse 37.
The book of Deuteronomy 28 and 37. And thou shalt become an astonishment.
And what?
And thou shalt become an astonishment.
An astonishment is a great wonder. Like what they say when they see our brothers 50 years old sagging in their pants, brother. That's an astonishment to the other nation, brother. And I, read on up.
And thou shall become an astonishment, a proverb, and a byword.
And a what?
And a byword.
African American. That's a byword. A byword is being called any name outside of your God-given name. God gave us Israel from the tribe of Judah, from the tribe of Manasseh, from the tribe of Issachar. These are our real nationalities, brother. God never called us African-American. He never called us these things, Negro. None of these things, brother. You won't find these things in the Bible, brother. You understand that, brother? Because where does the word African-American come from?
Something they made up.
Exactly. Something they made up. Come from two white men. Leo Scipio's Africanus and Amerigo Vespucci, brother. Give me Deuteronomy 28:46 right quick.
Those murderers.
Exactly. Murderers, brother. Because they came and conquered that place and changed the continent to their name. Read this,
This is Deuteronomy, chapter 28, verse 46. And they shall be upon thee for a sign.
What shall be upon us for a sign? What are we reading?
Curses.
Curses. So what shall be upon us?
Curses.
Curses, brother. Whoever, what nation of people fall upon these curses, guess what? That's who my chosen people is. Because the sign does what?
So what sign does what?
Yeah, what does the sign do? What is these signs telling you?
It tells us what's going on.
Exactly. It tells you what's going on. It identifies something. So when we read these curses, they identify who the real children of God is. You understand that? Read on up.
And for a wonder.
And for a wonder, to wonder, why do we go into slavery on slave ship? Why do we go, brother?
We want to keep it
together. Exactly, brother. It's just as simple as that, brother. It's not some deep theological wonder to amaze about, brother. Read on up.
And upon thy seed forever.
For what?
Forever.
Forever, brother. These curses are upon us to identify us. Because those fake Jews that's over there in the homeland, they never went into slavery on slave ships, brother.
That's right.
They never had to go through the hardships we do. They own the Diamond District. They own Hollywood. They own all these things, brother. But guess what? Our people own none of these things, brother.
That's right.
But guess what? It's hope, brother. That's what we are here to tell you. Give me Luke 13 and 3. That's what we are here to tell you, brother. The kingdom of heaven is yours, brother, if you repent and keep the commandments, brother.
That's right.
That's what you have to do. You got some more questions, brother? So how do we know who we are?
Curses.
In what chapter, though? What book?
What was that, Deuteronomy?
Deuteronomy, chapter 28, verse 15 through 68. Okay. Those list all the curses. And the most important person, guess what? Slave ships, brother.
Yeah.
You understand that? Read this out.
This is Luke 13, verse 3. I tell you, nay. But except ye repent.
Brother, except ye repent, brother, read on up.
Ye shall all likewise perish.
Ye shall all likewise perish. How do you repent, brother?
You gotta come to the Lord. You gotta surrender. You gotta come to the truth. You gotta talk to him truthfully. You gotta surrender.
Hold on. Let's one thing at a time. What is the truth according to the Bible? What's the truth?
The truth is accepting that we are sinners. You know what I'm saying? Accepting that that you fell short. Accepting that Jesus is the Son. I mean, Yahushua is the Son. You know, and accepting the Father's grace.
How about let us just read what the truth is?
Please do. I don't got my sword.
Yeah, because the Bible explains what the truth is, brother. We never have to go on our own interpretation. You understand that? We just find the scripture that says it and just read it. And more importantly, apply it. Let's see what the truth is. Read this out.
The book of Psalms, chapter 119, verse 122. Thy righteousness is an everlasting righteousness.
Uh-huh.
And thy law.
And thy what?
And thy law.
Parallax.
And thy law is the truth.
So what's the truth, brother?
Cross.
The law, brother. That's what the truth is. That's so when we keep the law, that's when you in the truth, brother. That's what we are to tell our people. Now let's go back, brother. Give me what you had. Luke 13 and 3. Read this out.
The book of Psalms, chapter 1, verse 1. Blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly.
Read that again for the brother.
Blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly.
Brother, you blessed when you're not walking in the counsel of the ungodly. That means sinners, brother. Read on up.
Nor standeth in the way of sinners.
Uh-huh.
Nor sitteth at the in the seat of the scornful.
Of the what?
Of the scornful.
Read on up.
But his delight is in the law.
Is in the what?
Is in the law of the Lord.
Brother, your delight should be in the word, in this law. Read on up.
And in this law does he meditate day and night.
Like we just read in Joshua, brother. The Bible is redundant. It say the same things over and over again, brother. Because the Most High know that we hard-headed rebellious, brother. So he constantly repents and still fit. Because he constantly repeats himself so we can get the message, brother.
Right.
You got some questions, brother?
No, brother, I'm listening, man. I appreciate y'all presence.
Brother, where do you live at, bro? You stay down here, bro?
Something like that. I stay on Gaston Avenue.
And you be painting? What is that, your occupation? Is that your job?
That's my study. That's my occupation. That's...
Brother, y'all, brother, you know your nationality according to the Bible? You believe in the Bible, bro?
Yeah,
bro.
I don't claim anything off the
dog. You said what now? Brother, I don't understand what you said, bro.
About your doctrine.
Brother, the Bible is its own doctrine. We ain't reading, we just reading out the Bible, man. I understand our people, man. Brother, stand, listen to us, brother. I'll see you listening for a little bit. Our people don't want to get this truth, brother. They don't understand, brother. This is the only way that's going to save your life, brother.
Man,
this is the only way that's going to get you through. Give me Revelation chapter. Give me Revelation chapter 12, verse 11, right quick.
Because
they don't understand, man. Destruction is coming to America. Brother, you know your nationality according to the Bible, brother? You believe in the Bible, brother? They don't care, man. They don't care when that lake of fire hit their ass, though.
Yeah,
they don't care then, bro.
That's right. No, that's right.
I heard about those missiles, man.
Read this. Exactly.
It's Revelation chapter 12, verse 11.
Read up.
And they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb.
Read that again, brother.
and they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb.
Brother, we got to overcome by the blood of the Lamb. The Lamb is Christ, brother. That's the only way we're going to get salvation, brother. We don't know.
And by the word of their testimony.
And by the what?
And by the word of their testimony.
Read up.
And they loved not their lives.
Read that again, up.
And they loved not their lives.
Read up.
Unto the death.
Brother, you can't love this life that we in, brother, because this life is full of sin, brother. We doing everything contrary to what the Bible is telling us to do. So that's these right. Brothers, myself, brother, we don't love our life. I hate seeing my paper in this situation, knowing that we're the greatest people on the planet, brother. That makes no sense. Give me 1 Peter 2 and 9, man. We're the greatest people on the planet Earth, brother. That's God right. Chose us to be above everybody, brother.
That's right.
But our people want to be below everybody. It makes no sense, man, because they don't want to keep commandments, man. Brother, we waiting on you to wake up, man.
The other nations just want to copy us.
They do, brother.
I don't even know why we follow them. That's crazy.
Yeah, you got to read this, huh?
The book of 1 Peter, chapter 2, verse 9. But ye are a chosen generation.
Wait a minute, what did God call us?
But ye are a chosen generation. A royal priesthood.
A what?
A royal priesthood.
Read up.
A holy nation.
A holy nation. What does the word holy mean?
Pure.
Separate. Read on, huh?
A peculiar people.
A peculiar.
That ye should show forth the praises of him who had called you out of darkness.
They called us out of what?
Out of darkness.
Right now, the Most High is calling you out of darkness, brother. Out of sin, brother. Read on up.
Into his marvelous light.
Because he's trying to get you to that marvelous light, brother. That marvelous light is the kingdom, brother. Rulership over the planet Earth and the people in it, brother. A lot of times, our people don't want this. They're so used to being on the bottom, brother. But guess what? We're here to break down those strongholds and build them up according to God's laws, brother. You understand that, man? That's what we all out here for, brother.
Thank you, brother. Thank you.
To get brothers to the kingdom, brother.
Thank you, because I didn't come into the truth until I started coming to the Israel brothers.
Like,
And when on my way here to Dallas, bro, I was reading the Bible and stuff, but I was lukewarm.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? And then, somehow,
give me Acts bro, chapter 8, verse 30.
I ain't gonna lie, bro, I resented the way y'all talked when I first saw y'all back in Milwaukee.
Give me Isaiah 58:1.
I didn't understand it because it was strange. It was different to me.
Uh-huh.
But that Bible brought me back to y'all.
Yeah, brought you back to God. Yeah,
it brought me back to, but it also brought me back to the right teacher.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Y'all are the right teacher.
We don't get all that for you. Read this right quick, God.
This is Acts chapter 8, verse 30.
Read up.
And Philip ran thither to him and heard him read the prophet Isaiah and said, understandest thou what thou readest?
So this man was asking the prophet Philip, do you understand what you are reading? That's what Philip asked this man. Read on up.
And he said, how can I? Except some man should give me, guide me.
Read that again, huh?
And he said, how can I? Except some man should guide me.
So guess what? You need a teacher that understand these scriptures, that guide you, brother.
And nobody, I haven't met anyone here.
Give me Isaiah 30 and 10 right quick. Read this up.
The book of Isaiah, chapter 58, verse 1. Cry aloud.
So the Bible commands us to cry aloud, brother. So in the past, when you saw us crying aloud, speaking loudly, that's a commandment, brother. We don't know.
Spare not.
And we can't spare your feeling. We got to tell you, thus saith the Lord, that you in sin, brother. We don't know.
Lift up thy voice like a trumpet.
Brother, you got any questions? Come on at us for a minute, man. Listen to this word, man. Come on, man. We're trying to get you to the kingdom, brother. Because you can look at that paper. Guess what? The prophets up here got the true understanding, brother.
That's right. Read on up. And so my people their transgression, and the house of Jacob their sin.
We need to show our people what they are doing wrong according to the scriptures. And guess what? Rebuke them sharply and get them to keeping God's laws. Read this, huh?
In Isaiah chapter 30, verse 10, which say to the seers, see not.
See what?
See not.
Read on,
Not unto us right things, speak unto us smooth things.
Because that's a lot of time our people want. They want us to tell them smooth things, brother. Not right things, not that. Guess what? A sister got to wear a dress. Men got to grow their beards. Men got to wear fringes, brother. Read on, huh?
Prophecy deceit.
Prophesy.
Prophesy deceit.
Prophesy deceit. Guess what? You can eat that pork as long as you pray over it. You can go to Sunday church. You can worship Christmas. You can worship your birthday. Read on. You can smoke weed. Read on, huh?
Verse 11. Get you out of the way. Turn aside out of the path.
Turn away what?
Turn aside out of the path.
A lot of times people want to get you off that path, brother. Read on up.
Because the Holy One of Israel to see from before us.
To what?
To see from before us.
Because a lot of times they want God to cease from before them, brother. Our people hate correction, brother.
Oh, yeah.
But this Bible is all about correction. You got something out? Yeah. Read this up.
The book of Exodus, chapter 19, verse 5. Now, therefore, if ye will obey my voice indeed.
Read that again.
Now, therefore, if ye will obey my voice indeed.
The voice of God is this Bible, brother. Read on up.
And keep my covenant. Then ye shall be a peculiar treasure unto me above all people.
No, equal to everybody.
Above all people.
No, blacks and Hispanics like to be the same with everybody.
Above all people.
Read up.
For all the earth is mine.
For all the earth is what?
All the earth is mine.
And this whole planet earth belongs to the Most High God, brother. Read on up.
And ye shall be unto me a kingdom of priests.
A kingdom of what?
Of priests.
Read up.
And an holy nation.
Read on.
These are the words which thou shalt speak unto the children of Israel.
Of who?
Of Israel.
No, African American.
Of Israel.
This Bible was only spoken to the children of Israel. This one talk spoken to everybody. Sis, you don't believe in the Bible, sis? You don't like how we come right out into our people, sis? Where in the Bible does it tell you to wear a cross around your neck?
Bring it out, huh?
Is that any scripture in the Bible? How can we wear something that our Lord and Savior was persecuted about? Brother, what are you doing? You trying to take her away from the word, brother? Because we got... Give me Mark 4 and 14. Because we got a scripture for that, brother, too, man. Brother, come deal with us.
What? Who am I that I owe anybody anything?
Brother, that's not what that scripture is talking about, brother. You out here looking to breathe yet. Are you drunk out here? Are you drunk out here, brother? Give me first, but you got 5 minutes, brother. I know your job. I know you're tired, brother. But you need to come get these scriptures, brother. Oh, praise y'all. Get that brother hand, man. Brother, I know you're tired, man, because I know Esau got us in captivity, brother. He wearing out the saints, brother. You know your nationality according to the Bible? You done heard about this before?
I've been hearing about it, yeah, but not really, though. I mean...
What's your nationality? What nation of people do you come from?
Bloodline, African, Jamaican.
That's what we've been taught. What's your father, brother? What is your father? What race is your father?
Oh, he's black.
He's black. Yes, sir. Look at your skin. Is your skin black?
It's not black like it's not
exactly black. Your shirt is black.
Yes.
That's not a nationality, that's a color in the crayon box. That's what we are here to tell you. So if your father's a so-called black man, you will be from the tribe of Judah, brother. Guess what? That is biblically in the Bible, brother. Do you understand that? Guess who else came from the tribe of Judah? Christ came from the tribe of Judah.
Right.
So that's saying, guess what? You have the same blood as Christ, brother. We come from the tribe of Judah, that's out right. Of the nation of Israel, brother. Therefore, we are the Israelites that the Bible speaks of.
That's
and that's
right,
what
we're yeah.
going to tell our people, brother. We know this because of the curses in Deuteronomy, brother. How did our forefathers come to America? You know, say
something. They were dragged over.
Exactly, brother. Yeah. What was the transportation? On who?
On the boat,
let's get that for the brother. Bam, there it is right there. Now let's pull it out of the scriptures. Give me Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 15.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, verse 68.
Verse 15.
But it shall come to pass.
This was a future prophecy Moses given the children of Israel when we came out of Egypt. Read on up.
If thou would not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God.
We won't listen to the voice of the Lord thy God, this Bible.
To observe. And to do all his commandments.
How many commandments are there, brother?
10.
Brother, it's over 613 right. commandments.
Well, that was the program we was taking.
Exactly, brother. That's why we're trying to deprogram you and program you back with God, all of God's laws. Read on up.
And his statutes which I command thee this day. That all these curses.
That all these what?
That all these curses.
Now, is a curse a good or a bad thing?
It's supposed to be a bad thing.
It is a bad thing, brother. Yeah. It's nothing good about a curse, brother. Read on up.
Shall come upon thee and overtake thee.
So clear and cut, God said, for breaking my commandments, I was going to make bad things happen to you, brother. It's a flip side. If we keep the commandments, we'll be set on high. But if we break them, guess what? We'll put below everybody. Ain't we below everybody as a nation of people, brother?
Yeah.
Ain't we on the bottom? Let's get 68.
Verse 68. And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again with ship.
With what?
With ship.
Now, what were the children of Israel doing in the land of Egypt, brother? Do you know anything about the Bible?
I think they was building.
That was what? They was building, exactly. But they was what? Slaves, brother.
Yes.
So Egypt has a meaning. Read this out.
Deuteronomy chapter 5, verse 6.
Uh-huh.
I am the Lord thy God, which brought thee out of the land of Egypt, from the house of bondage.
From the house of what?
Of bondage.
So what did he call Egypt?
Bondage.
Bondage. What is another name for bondage? When somebody... Slaves, brother. Slavery, brother. So what does Egypt mean? Slavery, brother. So now we got the correct understanding. Let's go back. Read this, huh?
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, verse 68. And the Lord shall bring thee into slavery again with ship.
With what?
With ship.
With what?
With ship.
Transatlantic slave trade.
With ship.
Who is the only race of people going to slavery on slave ships, brother? Last, brother. We went into slavery. Because did all races go into slavery on slave ships? No, they did not, brother. So that is one curse that what identifies with us, brother. That lets you know who we are, brother. God said, whoever is going up under these curses, those are my chosen people, brother. Read on.
By the way, whereof I spake unto thee.
The same way Moses said it was going to happen, did it not happen, brother? Look at that, brother. Packed us on that boat like sardines, brother. Could you imagine being it? Yes, brother. That was us. Read on, huh?
Thou shalt see it no more again.
And we want to go see it no more again. What is the it that the Bible is talking about? Our homeland.
Okay.
What's our homeland, brother? I know you know. What's our homeland? That's what we've been taught.
Yeah.
But if we are the Israelites, our homeland is what?
Israel,
brother. That's where we're from. That's who we be, brother. Read on up.
And there ye shall be sold.
What happened when we got off those slave ships? Sold, brother. Can't you see how you might, how this is lining up with us, brother? This didn't happen to everybody, brother. Read on, brothers and sisters. Y'all stay and listen to this word, man. We out here for our people, brother. That's what we out here to do, teach our people their nationality according to the Bible. Y'all ain't never wanted to know why y'all read in this Bible and y'all don't see African-American in the Bible. If God is all-knowing and all-powerful, then he know we're going to be African-Americans. That's because God never called us that. He called us Israel from the tribe of Judah, from the tribe of Manasseh, from the tribe of Issachar. Read on, now.
And there ye shall be sold.
And there we shall be what?
And there ye shall be sold.
What happened when we got those slave ships, brother? We was what? We was sold, brother. Nigga here sold to Master Williams down in West Virginia. Nigga sold to Master Williams down in Charlottesville. Read on up.
Unto your enemy.
Unto what?
Unto your enemy.
What nation of people sold us, brother? Bro, what nation of people sold us as a people? Caucasians, brother. Read that again.
And there ye shall be sold unto your enemy.
Unto our what?
Unto your enemy.
Unto our friends.
Unto your enemy.
Y'all listen to this on the way, man. This is for y'all, man. This is for you. Come back, man. So what did the Bible call them? Read it again.
And there ye shall be sold.
Our enemies, brother. Because do they treat us like they are friends, bro? No, they don't, bro. Not as a nation of people.
Not seeing the history of it.
Exactly, brother. Let's go back. You ain't got to go back long, brother. But they've been doing us wrong for thousands of years, bro. That was the prophecy that was in the Bible, brother. We won't go never get along with them, bro.
Thanksgiving just passed.
Exactly. Yeah. Guess what Thanksgiving was? The slaughter of the Native American Indians. They are from the tribe of Gad, brother. Those are our brothers and sisters. So when we celebrate that, guess what? We celebrate the slaughter of our own people, brother. They play on our ignorance, brother. But we no longer can be ignorant, brother. Where you get your...
Yeah.
We can't be defeated, let them know from the door. We won a lot of battles, but there's more in store. If you're gonna be a soldier, know what you're fighting for. We the battle axis, God's weapons of war. We can't be defeated, let them know from the door. We won a lot of battles, but there's more in store. If you're gonna be a soldier, know what you're fighting for. We the battle